The year 2022 started with a full reopening of the country from the COVID-19 pandemic-induced lockdown, which spanned for nearly 2 years. The reopening took shape in a staggered manner, with schools reopening on January 10th, ending the world's longest school disruption due to the COVID-19 pandemic. In February, a controversial coffee agreement was signed between the government of Uganda and Uganda Vinci Coffee Company Limited, awarding Vinci exclusive rights to process and export Uganda coffee, which angered Ugandan coffee farmers and politicians. After generating mass uproar from the public, Parliament intervened and passed a resolution recommending government to terminate the agreement.
Mr. Chairman, which was processing coffee very well, and all the coffee in Uganda was ending at Bugorobi after having gone through different stages, leaving the Banyankole Equatorial and all those arrangements. Now, we are earning money out of this, but it is you again who sold Bugorobi to give to Kananathan, and later on it was bought by a Ugandan from Masaka, Mr. Muhijira.
Impact on the economy.
Before the uproar over the Vinci controversial coffee deal could settle, President Museveni went to Chibuku District and launched the much-anticipated Parish Development Model Program, a program government is banking on to lift 17.5 million Ugandans in 3.5 million households out of poverty.
The model is a revolving fund and warned against misusing it.
This is now getting out of poverty through agriculture.
So, chinache tulikolo atianu, niko kuzomu wavu nga tuvita mubyo kulima.
But agriculture is not the only way of getting out of poverty.
The country went cold in March after the news of the death of the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, was announced by the President via his Twitter handle. Olanya passed on at a hospital in Seattle in the U.S. where he was getting super specialized treatment. The cause of his death attracted controversy as some people, including his father, claimed that he succumbed to poison.
I am not mourning in vain. I want to state clearly, Jacob was poisoned.
Even before he was laid to rest, a political storm rammed into Parliament as a battle to succeed the late took shape. Anita Among was elected Speaker of Parliament after defeating opposition candidate Asuman Basalirwa, while the government chief whip Thomas Tayebwa was elected a deputy speaker in a landslide victory against Chioga County MP Okot Pibitek.
A day I never imagined would happen this soon, especially because I believed for the next 5 years or 10 years I would still be the deputy speaker and Jacob would be the speaker. I would have had a strong mentor and a stronger leader in Jacob.
Teaching in public schools then went on a standstill in June as Ugandan arts teachers laid down tools and declared strike, demanding the government to increase their pay after being provoked by a huge pay rise for science teachers by over 30%. Although the strike never yielded fruits, it brought education on its knees. Politics has been another theater of drama this year, with the Democratic Party president, Genun Norbert Mao, signing a cooperation agreement. President Yoweri Museveni of NRM, which secured Mao a position in cabinet as a Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs. This sparked off dust from the opposition. The death of General Eddie Tumwine, who fired the first bullet in the NRA guerrilla war that brought President Museveni in power, can't go unnoticed this year. As Uganda was still celebrating the final investment decision to see the first oil production by 2025, the European Parliament passed a resolution stopping the East African crude oil pipeline over environmental concerns. This sparked off backlash from the Ugandan government, accusing the EU for entrenching energy poverty in poor countries. The tweeting, General Muhoozi Kainerugaba is another character that has dominated headlines in 2022. His tweets about Uganda invading Kenya can't be forgotten as it attracted a storm on social media. It took his father, President Yoweri Museveni, to apologize to Kenya and drop him as a commander of land forces after promoting him to a general. As the dust of COVID-19 settled, Ebola outbreaks were announced in Mubende in late September, which forced the president to put Mubende and Kasanda districts on a lockdown to curb the spread of the virus. The first lockdown was for 21 days before it was extended for more two times until December 17th, when the two districts were freed. Issues of torture, abductions, and enforced disappearances have continued to dominate space in 2022, with several reports of abductions reported at different intervals. Opposition has made it an agenda that has dominated several platforms in and outside the country. In the evening of 2022, assailants launched attacks on police posts and stations, stealing guns and killing some police officers. They started with Busika Police Station in Luwero District, hacking two police officers to death and fleeing with two guns. The look-alike series of attacks on police posts forced police to close several posts. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.